see why you spend lots of money on brakes and gas down there? Uh-huh. Up and down the hill. Very mountainous island. Very, very mountainous. And that is because it's a volcanic island. It's not coral like Barbados. On the brand and the model. On average, you would pay like $20,000. You could even get a nice car for $10,000. Yeah. Maybe second hand, that is. Not new.
Yeah.
Yeah, second hand, you know, good condition, get a nice car. But most of the cars you get from the island, on the island, is ordered from Japan. Nissan, Toyota, these ones. These are the most common ones you're going to see around. We also have some of those luxury cars like Lexus, BMW, Audi. Right. But these would be like business owners, politicians, driving those. There's your roller coaster ride for today.
Oh, yeah.
Plenty of them on the island. Just like bananas, coconut is like all year round. You never miss coconut out here. That's why we always have the green jelly coconuts, so we have the dried ones. And then we make coconut cakes, we make coconut candies, we use coconut oil for all our stuff. Yeah. Very, very healthy though, coconut oil. So if you recognize so far, a lot of the homes are built on stilts.
Yeah.
Yes, anybody has any idea why that is?
Taxation.
Floods. Yes, floods is a better answer. Floods in low-lying areas?
Yeah, the water comes down off the hills.
Well, around there, it wouldn't be such a problem. Like a coastal area, it would be wise to build on stilts.
Yeah.
Because they know when the waves are coming in, there's rough seas, yeah, that would be a good idea. Some people who live in areas which have snakes, yeah, to avoid the snakes, you gotta build high. Now, it's the main reason is like tradition. You build very high, so later you're gonna build at the bottom. So you can, if your kids don't want to go build a house as yet, and they want to build a nice little apartment to the bottom of the house, yes, that's easy to do. It's already high, so you just build at the bottom. Now, where we left your boat, your ship, there was the Caribbean Sea. We're going to be seeing little bits of the Atlantic Ocean. If what you're seeing over there, there's the Atlantic Ocean over there, to the east. Bananas a while ago, I didn't mention that banana, green banana with salted codfish is our national dish. You cook the green bananas the same way you cook green plantains. And you gotta boil the salted cod to remove a lot of the salt in there. And then you're gonna saute that with your green seasonings, put it right next to the banana, a slice of avocado in there, and that's it. National dish. That is very good, I can tell you that. Save the best for last, don't worry.
Oh.
There's a little hill, the Atlantic right there.
Oh.
There is the Atlantic. Always very rough though.
This is the Atlantic.
Want me to get a picture for you?
Yes, can you do that please?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay,
all right. Everybody can see those fruits. All right,
yeah, man, I tell you what I want to do.
Let me
but see,
mango.
I'll put it.
That's a different
variety.
Those are mangoes.
Yeah, there's a mango in there. That's a, this one we call the blue mango.
Yeah.
Okay, and in Creole we say mango blé. Blé means blue.
Do they all taste about the same?
Oh, no, they vary in texture, especially. Some are stringy, some are not. Some are a little sweeter than others. You know, some are kind of sour.
Yeah. That tastes like every kind.
You have some, yeah. Some of them just look nice.
Oh, yeah.
Are you allowed to pick whatever you want to drive down your road?
Like, if there's a tree of mangoes right there,
yeah.
And there's a house right there, what I got to do is just tell the folks, I'm getting some mangoes for my guests, and that's it.
They don't charge anything.
They don't charge anything. Because most likely they won't even pick it.
Yeah.
It's good to waste. Bananas right there. See those?
Pick banana of anything.
Just gotta ask. If there's no house, just go ahead.
Let's say you can't find anybody. Well, pick them anyway.
There's nobody in the house, go ahead. Just don't let the neighbor see you.
So what do they do for sewage? They have septic tanks.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. Usually at the side of the house, like about 6 feet deep. Yeah, so most people have those on the side of their houses. Some have them under the houses, different people.
An office. An office, or
whatever.
Huh? An office, usually, it's where. And it's a good time to go
to the
house. What else? All the hotels, everything is swap.
What do they do for running water?
You like drinking water?
Yeah.
Oh, our drinking water is that simple. Rain water into the reservoir, purify, distribute. That's it.
Yeah.
We never have problems with drinking water because remember I told you, just do 200 inches of rainfall.
Oh, yeah, it's a plenty of water.
There is a chocolate tree right there. Coco?
No.
The one we export? You see some purple pods in there?
Yeah. Huh?
It's very kind of very hard to see. There are some yellow ones also. The cocoa pods.
Yeah.
They're right in there. It's kind of difficult to see, yeah.
That's a cocoa tree.
Now it starts off this color and then it turns into stripe.
Huh?
Yeah, well, that's good.
Okay, right here.
Here's chocolate. You have nutmeg.
Yes. Yeah. Nutmeg, cinnamon, vanilla also. Vanilla vine, yeah. But the vanilla vine is like an orchid, so you have to do some kind of pollination to get your vanilla pot. Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. Now, with all that... those fresh fruits and vegetables around and all those herbs. Most people usually ask me, a lot of folks on the island, are they very healthy? That used to be the case before, but now it's different because all those fast food restaurants down here now, yep, people leave the good stuff and they go get the bad stuff. So that's why there's an alarming rate of diabetes, hypertension on the island. And it's alarming, it's getting out of hand. Oh yeah.
A kitty.
Do they have city buses that come out of people? It's just going to off the side of
another kitty.
You mean public buses?
Yeah, yeah.
Yes, public transport. If you, when we were going through the city, these are public buses.
Okay.
They're stationed in different parts of the city, they take you to different parts of the island. Yes, the further you go, more money you pay. Oh, yeah.
You know, all these people up here can't own cars.
Cleveland on those hills.
so great. No.
Oh, God.
Yep, get back up.
And if you see any black tanks next on the side of the houses, water cisterns, this is like people have it as backup when it gets a little bit like the dry season and the water. There's water, but it's not so, you know, you don't get so much of it. Yeah, so you have it as backup just in case it gets too dry and you have a little bit of a shortage. Sometimes the government usually assigns certain public buses to the schools, so the kids will get on, go to the city, or stay in the city, wait for the bus, and come up to the school.
Okay.
Yeah. It's easy to get around if you don't have a car. But pretty much the public bus system usually ends around 8, 9. So if you want to do anything or you want to go to anywhere after that time, you're going to have to get a taxi or a friend with a car or something. Lots of folks have cars now because people, like I just mentioned, the public bus system ends around 9, 8, 9. So lots of people are becoming frustrated with that, so they just get their own cars. So yeah, there's a lot of folks with cars on the island now. So that's why usually when we're going down sometimes or coming up to through the highways, it's a lot of traffic. Crime rate is very controlled. We hope it stays that way. Yes, because people complain to me a lot about the other islands, like Jamaica and Trinidad, where it's like very out of hand. But down here, people are behaving. You get a little bit of everything, but pretty much the police officers are relaxing in there, having donuts. So we hope it stays that way. We really hope. Either get a job over wherever they went to study, like United States or England, they would stay. Especially if they have family over there, they would just stay with the family and work, and they would come back to go on vacation. Some of them would go over there, get qualified, and when they come back there, sometimes they overqualified. The island cannot really pay them, especially like doctors. Yeah, they kind of like overqualified, so they won't. The hospitals out there can't really pay them, so sometimes they're gonna have to go back over there look for a job, you know. Or some of them is going to have to settle for another job because they can't get paid for their profession. Yeah, so it's kind of that way sometimes. But unemployment, the rate of unemployment is, for a small island, 24%. That's pretty high for a small island. Now, something that helps the unemployment rate a bit is very common now is the cruise ship jobs. It's a big thing now. Cruise ship jobs. Yes. The cruise lines? Yeah. Before it is very hard to get on a cruise line, you know, because there were the agencies down here. But now we have agencies that train you and send you on board. And if you're unemployed, you know, you cannot afford the expenses to get on the cruise ship to work, the banks and the government will come together and give you like a student loan. They will take up all the expenses on all the classes and stuff. But when you go on the ship, you make the money, you just pay it back. Yeah, so they send lots of kids on board the cruise ships every year. Someone asked earlier about breadfruit. Right over there.
Oh, that's
breadfruit. That's breadfruit. I call it a potato. It's similar to a potato. You could do chips, you could make a pie, you could do anything with breadfruit. And you could do it with potato. Oh, yeah. They get way bigger than that. The size maybe close to a basketball. Yeah, so they get pretty big. So you have one, you could feed a family of like 8 people with one.
Oh.
It's very big, yeah.
What does that cost?
At the market, based on the size. They would sell them like $5 for one, and sometimes they would give you a heap of smaller ones for $10. Yeah, about 3 of them in the heap, yeah. Different prices, different size. This was brought into the island in the 17th century by Captain Bligh. We're getting a better view when we go to the place up there. See the north of the island. Actually, when we get to the garden area, the place where we're stopping, you're gonna see one of them. It's on the causeway in the north of the island. That's one. It's called Simon's Grand. And there are two other ones. Comes with this one. Well, further down. When we're going down, we're gonna see another one. And there's another one in that area on the west coast. Yeah. Approximately 40 minutes at that place. The washroom's available. You're going to meet the owner of the place, Mr. Sonic. He's going to tell you about the place. He's going to be directing you as to where you can go to see what. Okay, so you're going to have your free time, 40 minutes. It's your time. Walk around, take photos, sample the refreshments, sample the banana ketchup, take lovely photos, enjoy that time, okay? Now, you can leave your heavy bags if you have any heavy bags or bulky stuff. You can leave it in the bus, you just hold your light stuff like your wallet, your camera, and stuff like that. You want to see how you earn a PhD? You're in the first of the hill.
This is Stony Hill.